Hello and welcome to. Well, this will be the last time that you'll get to see Minecraft on the main Meister server. It's been an interesting month. A few people managed to get on to the server and have a little play. And, well, the only thing that I could really do, really, was encourage people to come onto it. But I also wanted to sort of promote Main Meister's channel a little bit and get people interested in Minecraft again. Rob managed to come on and do some stuff on it, which I was very happy about. And a few others managed to come on. We had some interesting ideas. One of those ideas was to do some pixel art. So this will be the last time we'll look at this because it gets switched off literally in about 5 6 hours time. But you can see I did do some pixel art. I'll just go over here. Look, I did a Donkey Kong out of wool, and I did a Mario who's just above a cave that's over there. We'll go over there in a minute. These were very easy, really. If you don't have a sprite editor, the way I did this was I found some sprites that you could find easily on a Google search, and then used Excel and filled in Excel with colored blocks. And that's pretty much how I did those. So there's nothing really special going on. We're just going to do some tidying up for the last time. Oh, and just get rid of some of this stuff. It's not going to be needed anymore, poor old server. But hey, it doesn't mean it's the end. I might find another server if people are interested. I've got no problems with starting something up. I think really it's just a matter of time and interest, really, with this. Just gonna go over here. Get these odds and sods. I don't really need to do this, but hey, it's sort of like a momentous last thing to do. Get rid of all of this. There's some interesting things like these turtles. Now I found out, or I learned that turtles, they sh when they're small, they shed their skins and grow larger, and the shedding of their skin, that element that they leave behind apparently is very sought after in the game. These were already grown, so to be quite honest, it was a waste of time really keeping them there. And I didn't learn anything about whether you can farm them or anything like that. So I'm just gonna plant these things down one last time because it's a bit of fun, really. Boom, boom, boom. I don't know if I've mentioned it already because I've already got a mind like a colander. I would have said sieve, but colander's got bigger holes. That I've saved the world just in case. It means I can play it offline. I could upload it to another server. But really, this is just, I thought it'd be nice just to have a little last look, really, to be quite honest. Lots of things we could have done together, server, but time ran out, and the people that own the server, their prices were quite high after the first month that it didn't really warrant it, to be quite honest. Just to give you an idea, the first month was the price of a pint of lager in England. The following month, if you wanted to have the correct amount of RAM for the amount of users, like 20 plus, you'd be looking at quadrupling that. And so really it was a no-brainer to say no really on that. But hey, if there are introductory deals somewhere else, definitely I would consider going back to it. And I think, like I say, my friend Robert, I think he got some enjoyment out of it. We found together or should I say, he found a nice underground cave where there was a ancient city, and we found that monster that's there that hides in the shadows. I think it's called the Caretaker or something like that. And so he got, I think, a lot of fun out of that and learned some things. I find Minecraft is all is what is another one of those games where it's all about the journey. It's what you learn, what you then take into the next time you play it, etc. etc. So here's something that I was going to do. I was going to do a bridge with some nice ornaments down the side and make some pillars, and it would have been nice to carry the boat to go around. So that was just something else. There's the Mario, the first thing I did against a grey backdrop. And as you can see, I could have tunneled some of this other stuff away, but I never got around to it. And then, of course, this was one of the last sort of caves that I went down. I don't think I did too much down here. It was another one of those ones where, oh, I'll do that at some point. And if I go down here, look, you'll see what I mean. I was tunneling down because the other thing I learned about Minecraft really is that's right, I found a cave down here. Is that the further you go down on the y-axis, the more you're likely to find gems and so forth. As you can see, I didn't do too much down here. Oh, there's a horrible thing. Well, he could have blown that up anyway because the world's going to be destroyed anyway. But as you can see, I didn't go down here too much. There's another one, look. Killed you. And it's just amazing how Minecraft has progressed. Look at these stalactites and so forth. Just absolutely brilliant when you consider my history with the game. Didn't have any of that when I was playing it. I mean, I just put things back even though I don't need to. Like I say, we'll just go back up. And it was, like I say, a very enjoyable little romp. Hope you like that pixel art. Didn't take very long, believe it or not. So we'll just head back to the house. Doesn't pixel art look weird when you're looking at it head on? It's just one single block. But when you look at it from the side, it looks like a massive Kong. Nice. Just get back to the world. It's getting dark. There's going to be loads of creatures coming out. There was going to be lots of things I was going to do here. So just open up this here for a moment and then go to sleep. There we go. Up here, I was going to do all the enchanting. So I was going to fill this with library books and an enchantment table. Most of the stuff that I built with this actually wasn't done with this equipment. It was through trading with the village. So that was quite nice. Kept a pig farm. There was the land that I'd found over in this corner because this is where I spent most of the time. But when we consider the beginning, it was all done in the snow, in the biome that we're just about to go back to. And it's nice to think back at this. I found a ship but I never managed to find any treasure in it because I didn't spend enough time investigating how you can breathe underwater longer. I did hear about using helmets and all of that sort of stuff. We're going to head back. I think it was this way. To the second house. You can see we're heading towards that frost area. And you can see there in the distance, there it is. The sort of frost biome in my house. Me just come out of here. We'll look at this house for the last time. And yes, that's right. I put these chests down here, didn't I? That's right. And I was going to do all my mining from here with that little starter house. With all these furnaces. Yeah, that was an interesting idea. And like anything at the beginning, I was so cautious. I went, all right, I'll build big pillars that tell me where everything is. And it was such a small starter house. Look, had a little wheat field. You had just enough room, look, to put a chest and something down. Really, really next to nothing. And we'll just eat some food. And we'd head off to the very, very first house for the last time. Which, as you can see, I didn't traverse too far, but I didn't do any of the cartography, the map drawing for this area. And I suppose I could have done, but I was hoping what would happen would that more people would come on and they would use that map that I've got there to branch out and we could build the maps together. But like I say, you can only do so much in a month, is how I look at it. And quite a bit got done. I believe my friend Robert built his base around this area. He did give me the coordinates. But I couldn't find it. But that didn't matter. That was his own base. There we are. You can see those big, long, elongated pillars that I built to show where I was, because I always found that I didn't know where I was half the time in the game. And so I needed to put torches everywhere just so I could find my way home. It's like Quantum Leap, always searching for the way home. But my name's not Sam Beckett, and I ain't as intelligent as all that. So this was the first home. And as you can see, look, I started to put up signs and all sorts of stuff. There was the bed. I was going to do all sorts of stuff down all of these alleyways. Didn't in the end. But it all sounds so sad, but it wasn't at all. So enjoyable. Going to need some more food again. Don't know how much time we're going to have before it gets dark. But there was one thing that Robert did find that I found very interesting. And he found this, it's like an obelisk on the top of this mountain. And I thought to myself, those are the gateways, aren't they, to get to the Nether. And he was going to come back to it, and he never did. And I built what I thought was what you needed to do, which was fill the outside with the other obelisks that you need, the other brick type that it needs. Obsidian, that's it. I couldn't think of the name then for a moment. And where was it now? It was was a little bit further along, not too far. But it didn't actually. I think you need to use the flint to make it actually do, to actually create it. But also, I think you don't actually have it as large. It's an old obelisk. It's part of a top city, and I think you can mine down and find things. Christ, there's been some trees been growing here. There we are. You can see it up there. So he found this obelisk, and I completed it. I don't know if we can get up there, because I took most of the ladders away. Might be able to. Yeah. As you can see, I took a lot of it away. And here we go. And I filled it in. I think you can dig down and you get a lot more knowing about what this is all about. But I found it so interesting what Robert was doing, but I didn't go any further. Look, I thought, oh, there's other things that Robert could do round here, and sort of like left it. Forgot where the ladders are now. Oh, there they are. Oh, that was stupid of me. Diddy-diddy-diddy-diddy-diddy. Eat some more. And I just head back to that old house for the final time, taking a little look and reminiscing. So I got amazing happiness and the fondness of doing this. And a lot, I learned an awful lot. And I'm not discouraged at all in regards to doing something like this again. And I really do urge you to look at Steve's gaming, where he's doing this on the Switch, and Rob's gaming, where he's doing his Minecraft run. I think he's up to episode 25 now. And definitely encourage you to look at some of the description in all of my videos, and look at all of these servers for MameMeister, 20th Century Gaming. They're all an absolute wicked bunch of people that bring out content all the time in many, many different areas and genres. And really, honestly, you can just get such immense pleasure. Watching other people's stuff, it brings back such happy memories, and you can learn some things as well. So I just get to the house, and then I'll call it an end. Ah, it sounds so bad when you say the end. But hey, maybe it's a new beginning. Who knows? Get into the house. It's getting dark. We'll look out the glass at that final sunset, which is looking lovely and orange. And I'll say salute, and thank you so much for watching this. And I've hoped you've enjoyed just looking back at some of the stuff that we did on our server, the MameMeister Minecraft server. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.